Hello friends, hope you are doing well. So today we will discuss about the core architecture of Commvault. Hope you have seen my previous videos where I have explained how deduplication works and how indexing works and how encryption works in Commvault, right? Please like my those videos and subscribe my channel for the latest updates on the videos for Commvault. And today we will discuss about the Commvault architecture and its components. Let's look at some of the core infrastructure components involved in the Commvault solution architecture. Each of these components I will explain in detail. Although the multi-tier data management architecture depicted here may not appear to be unique, you will shortly discover some key differences that set Commvault apart. As a whole, the components in a Commvault software environment constitute as a Commvault. Every console starts with a console, which acts as the command and control center in the console. Every Commvault environment has a console as its foundation. The command center is a powerful web-based user interface that provides a simplified service-oriented approach to managing on-premise and cloud infrastructures. This console offers an easy-to-use and flexible interface. And this console features out-of-box configuration that streamlines procedure and automates common tasks. Next is the media agent. The media agent is the data transmission manager, you can say, in the console environment. It provides high performance data movement and manages the storage targets. The console server coordinates media agent tasks. Fault stability. There can be more than one media agent in the console environment. The media agent software can be installed in physical or virtual or in a cluster environment as well. System whose data is managed by Commvault typically leverage a software package known as a server. Software packages known as a agent reside on the servers and provides a native file system and application awareness that allow for successful data management operations such as backups and restores. Finally, a storage target. A storage target is where data is stored when it is backed up. Disk, tape, and cloud storage can all be configured as a storage target. Commvault indexing and data packaging technologies are tightly integrated with these storage targets to provide a global virtualized storage repository. The Commvault act as the command and control center of the Commvault and handle all requests for activity between media agent and server components. The console serves four primary functions. It holds the centralized configuration database and the meta database for the console. The meta database catalog housed in the console includes metadata about the nature and location of the data where it is stored. It also acts as the central point of disaster recovery in an environment. The console houses a Microsoft SQL database with configuration and media association, which in a disaster recovery scenario is the first item that needs to be recovered. Next is the event orchestration. The console also houses the centralized event and job managers that handle the orchestration of various operations within a console. Finally, the console handles all the management of the security profiles and authentication processes. This is managed through local user security groups and through tight integration with external domains such as Active Directory. So next, the media agent, which we call as a data mover as well. The media agent is a high performance data mover server component in a Commvault environment. The media agent acts as a gateway between data stream from the servers being protected and the storage target where backup data will reside. The media agent accepts data from any server with the appropriate Commvault software package installed and then transport that data to a broad range of storage targets, including disk, tape, or cloud storage. Media agents are also used during auxiliary copy jobs, where data is copied from one storage target to another storage target. As we know, it does the duplication as well, and the data agent the media agent maintains a granular indexing information in its index cache, which includes detail on the jobs and objects that it processed. Part of this maintenance is the periodic pruning of data from the index cache in order to maintain a reasonable footprints. Media agent also typically media agent also typically the home for duplication databases environment. Another function that the media agent handle is that it interfaces with supported primary storage arrays for internal snapshot management, which we will discuss in upcoming videos. I will upload some more videos on the internet slab, especially for internet slab. Media agent can be installed on most major operating systems and platform for detailed information. Please, on the detailed information or the operating system which it supports, please refer to the documentation website. It is at documentation.commvault.com. Next component is the servers. A server is a system where you have installed one or more Commvault Cloudflare packages. It enabling you to perform data protection and recovery tasks. Commvault Complete Backup and Recovery supports the vast majority of operating systems, applications, databases, and hypervisors in the market. Commvault software packages directly enter with the file system or application requiring protection and provide the common functionality of Commvault services and utilities. The Commvault software packages include the provision of application aware and application consistent protection capabilities to ensure that the data is protected. And the data is protected in a consistent state and is recoverable in a valid and user format upon restore. Each server requiring protection will have at least one software package installed. There are some exceptions where a server facilitates the management of other systems. For example, virtual machines can be protected without requiring the installation of software package. That's the agentless backup of the VMs. When utilizing the Commvault virtual server agent, use the Commvault virtual server agent for that. Except that for every server which requires a protection will have at least one software package installed. The last Commvault server component I will explain is web server and web console. The web server hosts the Commvault REST API interface to communicate with the console. This allows access to console and end user operation through the command center, web console, and third-party REST API clients. The web console provides the web-based applications, including self-service functionality, that allows non-administrative users to perform data management operations such as backup, restore, download, etc. In addition, the web console allows user to run reports and execute automated workflows as well. Having said that, the admin console, or we can say command center, is a web-based user interface for administrative tasks. Additional web servers and web console can be installed on separate hardware to provide greater flexibility and or scalability in certain environment. Or we can install this web server and web console on the same machine where console is deployed. The final Commvault software component I will explain is the storage target. A storage target can be one of the following: a disk library that you associate with one or more mount paths. A mount path is a set of partitioned disks or arrays that is associated with a file system. A mount path can be a local disk or network attached storage device. Or a cloud library, a cloud library that you associate with a supported online cloud storage devices. Commvault is compatible with more than 20 option storage providers. Cloud storage provides the ability to easily increase your storage capacity as and when it required. It also provides centralized data access, better failover capabilities, and reduces the day-to-day storage administrator tasks. Finally, a tape library. A tape library can be configured that is attached to the media agent. Please note, for configuration of the tape library, media agent has to be on physical. Commvault Software's robust indexing engine provides a common catalog and awareness of stored data regardless of where it resides, where it originated from, or how it got there. So Commvault Software capability to add additional storage as need demand is not new. This ability has always been a key differentiator of our solution. Storage can easily be added to the storage can easily be added to house the data whenever and wherever it is needed. Commvault Software allows organization to leverage these core infrastructure components to handle a wide variety of information and data management functions, including data protection and recovery, archive of data for capacity optimization purposes, reporting and analytics. The management and induction of hardware-based snapshot into an overall data management strategy, data replication, search and analytics, automation, migration, deduplication, and disaster recovery. These functions may be applied. These functions may be applied across both physical and virtual environment for structured and unstructured data, both on-premise in the cloud and at the edge, spanning different servers, platforms, hypervisors, applications, and display storage platforms. With Commvault Software, organizations are able to leverage shared infrastructure, consolidate and centralize the management of these functions, apply common processes across their environments, and maximize their storage efficiency by leveraging global deduplication. Effectively, this allows customers to minimize their learning curve associated with data management designed for availability and disaster recovery in a holistic fashion, and minimize the amount of times that data required processing. By doing so, the deployment of Commvault Software can drive significant economic savings for organizations as well as dramatically increase the efficiency of their operations. Commvault Software is also known for its scalability. As you are aware, it's very famous for scalability. As the number of clients being managed in an environment or the data sets those clients generate increase to a threshold where the original number of media agents cannot accommodate a customer's established protection and recovery SLAs, it is very simple process to scale the environment by deploying additional media agents to accommodate the load. This core infrastructure, this core architecture also facilitates backend scaling of deduplication and non-duplication storage. As an environment grows and more capacity is consumed, Commvault Software alerts users and allow them to easily add additional storage. For example, if a storage pool is nearing capacity, user can additional mount paths to the storage target. Yes. So they can add additional mount path to the storage target in order to seamlessly increase its capacity. These mount paths can potentially be from different storage arrays provided by different vendors. This also helps to provide our customers with flexibility to balance both performance and cost in terms of the storage. Now lastly, let's discuss about the logical component in a Commvault environment. First up, plans. Plans we configure through the Commvault admin console, or we can say the command center. These are used to simplify data protection. In a plan, you define what to backup, where to backup, and how often to run the backup jobs. These are plan types that includes the data protection parameters that apply to the type of data you want to protect. Base plan acts as a template to create what are known as derived plans. You can also set default plans that can be automatically assigned to new servers to ensure your data is protected. So you have option for SAM plan, database plan, server plan, laptop plan, Exchange inbox plan, and virtualization plan. These plans are mapped to service levels after the backup frequency and the backup window are defined. Commvault uses automatic scheduling and dynamic priorities to achieve your defined RPOs. Finally, more comprehensive plans can be created for certain use cases. For example, if a customer wants their data to be managed in a very specific way, so they can go with some custom plans. Next, the server groups. A server group is a logical grouping of the server computers. You can create server computers groups so that you can define option one time and then have the option assigned to all server group members. Server groups are created for any number of reasons. Some of the most common reasons are grouping for sake of security, for the sake of reporting, automatic updates, geographical management, for example, to allow for different schedule policies to be applied depending on time zones, etc., etc. Server group may also be created to accommodate business requirements. For example, different functional group in an organization may have different service level associated with the production of their data. Server group can easily accommodate scenarios such as this. As depicted here, a particular client may belong to multiple server groups. Finally, server group can be configured using automatic association that follow a user-defined set of rules. Based on these rules, existing or new server are added, or they can be removed to the server group automatically. Hope you have liked my video. Please share the video and subscribe my channel to get the updates on the latest videos on Commvault. Thank you.